With more than 2,000 lavender plants in 11 different varieties, you can pick out your own and even learn how to use lavender for skincare, decorating, or in food. Jennifer headed to Georgetown to check out the You Pick Lavender Farm.
So it started about 6 years ago with a family vacation to Seattle, and we were looking for outdoor activities to do. And one of the things we discovered was that there was about 15 or 20 lavender farms around Seattle, so we decided to go visit. We just fell in love with the plants and the flowers and smell and all the different things you could do with lavender. And I wanted to wait till we retired to start a lavender farm, but my wife wanted to start right away. So we started right away.
How has lavender and bloom grown, I guess literally and figuratively, since you started the business?
Well, the first year we had trouble growing the plants. The weeds took over and they all died. So we replanted and kind of took some classes and realized how you're supposed to do it in Kentucky, because it's not native to Kentucky. So we had a lot to learn. But I think the word of mouth has really helped, and we just keep trying to tell more people about it. And this is our fourth year having our U-Pick. So we have more people than ever that have contacted us about the lavender.
We've also done You Pick Tulips. We started that this spring. We did 25,000 tulips, and that was a big hit, too.
You Pick events, those are on Thursdays, right? How does that work, where the public can come and enjoy lavenders in bloom?
We have a schedule made out. We will, it's on our website, lavenderinbloom.farm. We are open on the weekends, Saturday and Sunday, 10 to 5, for about 4 more weeks. And then we do have some scheduled times Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday. And we ask that people purchase tickets beforehand because we're just a small family operation. And we want to make sure if we need to get extra help for a certain day that we can do that.
You have a lot of neat events, too, that the public can be part of, from wreath making to making bath bombs. What are some of the other ways that people can enjoy lavender and bloom?
We have a painting class this Friday night, painting on the farm, and all ages, no experience necessary. It's just fun to sit out and be creative. And then, Saturday, wreath making and bath bomb making. We have yoga in the field. We have Shannon Strickland from the studio coming next Friday. And this is her third year she's done yoga in our field. So that should be a real fun experience. So hope everybody can make it out for that.
Where can people find you, and where can they learn more about Lavender and Bloom?
Well, our website is lavenderandbloom.farm. We have all our information posted there. But we're also on the bypass in Georgetown on 426 Clellan Circle. We've got these purple and white flags hanging out in front, so it really makes it difficult to find us.